Good morning, Pally.
Today is Tuesday, March 5th, 2024.
I'm Carina Tong.
And I'm Spencer Buchin. Hey, Carina, have you seen the new InFocus staff Instagram page?
Yes, there are some lovely images of our fellow staff members there.
I think you should follow it to see more pictures of Anish Tiwari, as well as blue-themed song recommendations for Beck Lyons.
Last Friday, Pali Theatre hosted its first ever international night to celebrate various cultures in the Pali community through performing arts. InFocus reporter Henry Leins was on the scene.
What's up, Pali? We're here at Pali Theatre's first ever international night, embracing cultures and connecting communities through performances. Let's take a look, shall we?
I've been really connected with my culture since birth, I'd say, and then especially since nowadays there is war in Ukraine. So I just thought that if I were to perform this night, maybe more people would know that it's not just like Ukrainians are not just said refugees running around. We also have our own culture. We also have our own dances, music, songs. So that was the motive behind my performance.
Athia Paramesh is part of the theater program and the organizer of International Night. She explains the impact that the event had on the community.
On one end, it's like good for people to get to see the theater as like a community space, because something we don't want is for it to people to think that it's like just performing arts kids gets to use the stage. And like, we wanted the stage to really be for everyone. So that's why we opened it up to the whole community. And I thought that part was really cool because our stage is super beautiful and we have just such a beautiful space. And on the other end, it's just super impactful for other people to get to see cultures represented. To see your own culture represented is really impactful. And then also to get to celebrate other cultures is a really beautiful thing as we try and come together as a more global community. And we realize that there are more things that unite us than divide us.
For InFocus, I'm Henry Leins, co-reporting with Eddie Miao.
Thanks, Henry. Avatar The Last Airbender recently received a live-action adaptation. InFocus reporter and longtime Avatar fan Beck Lyons reviews the new live-action show.
The trend of live-action remakes has grown steadily over the past few years. With these companies exhausting every single one of their properties from the 90s, we have moved on to the era of 2000s remakes, and one of the most iconic properties of the 2000s is Avatar The Last Airbender. Breaking audience records, winning countless awards, and critical acclaim has cemented Avatar The Last Airbender as one of the best shows ever made. Even today, it sits as number 7 on IMDb's top 250 TV shows of all time. The story behind Netflix's live-action adaptations had an interesting development history. The show was first announced in 2018, but faced trouble in 2020 when the creators of the original show left due to creative differences. In 2021, it was announced that Albert Kim would take on the role of the showrunner of the live-action adaptation. It is reported that each episode of the live-action cost $15 million to make, making the total for the entire show around $120 million. The original show was 20 23-minute episodes in season 1. However, the live-action changes it to 8 hour-long episodes in season 1. Now having seen the show, I would like to talk about the many problems I have with it. First is that it is too serious. The original show was goofy with some serious moments. This adaptation removes all of the goofy moments and takes itself way too seriously. The show also decides to remove the entire reason of Book 1. Do you know why it's called Book 1 Water in the original? Because Aang learns waterbending! In this version, he doesn't bend a single bead of water or train waterbending at all the entire season. This is such a big change, I have no idea how they're gonna fix the timeline where he doesn't even know waterbending at the end of season 1. It feels like they have ripped the personality out of all of the main characters. Aang is no longer goofy and has no fun side adventures. Katara feels like she's had her spine removed and is this shy waterbender throughout the entire season, not the fierce and confident character that we see throughout the original. Sokka has also had all of his negative aspects removed, making him feel like the most generic character ever written. The entirety of Team Avatar is just like pale imitations of the original versions. But what does the show do good that doesn't make me scream like a madman? The show does a cool thing of maybe combining two or three episodes together into one and integrating them. It's really cool to see these original episodes done remixed. It's not better than the original, but it's cool to see if you're a fan of it. There are some really good new scenes. I like the one where Iroh is confronted by the brother of someone who died during the 600-day siege. I thought that was a really good scene and gave more depth to him earlier in the show. And I think one of the best changes of the show is the extra backstory we get behind Zuko's crew. It's a completely new idea that we didn't see in the original, but it makes it so much better. I personally think that animation is the better medium for this story, but the live action has some great visuals, especially in wide shots. In conclusion, Netflix's Avatar: The Last Airbender has some major flaws when relating to the plot, but has good visuals and cool remixes of episodes from the original. However, it cannot stand toe-to-toe with the original in any aspects. I recommend this show for fans who'd like to see the original stories done slightly differently. But if you haven't seen anything about Avatar: The Last Airbender, I'd recommend the original so you can see the story in its truest form.
For InFocus, I'm Beck Lyons.
Thanks, Beck. That does it for today's show.
Follow us on social media at InFocus News to engage with our content and visit our website to view today's campus bulletin.
Until next time, I'm Carina Tong.
I'm Spencer Buchan. And this has been InFocus News.
Have a great day, Vikings.